Hi, I'm Jordan Mallon. I'm a paleontologist here at the museum. And I'm going to be talking to you today about three different specimens that we have in our collections, which encompass, you know, well over 10,000. And the first I'm going to start with is a specimen. It's a skull of Triceratops that my student Matt Rollison is studying. And this specimen is important to us both because we spent some time this summer looking for lost Triceratops quarries in Saskatchewan, and we managed to find where this specimen was dug up from in Grasslands National Park by Charlie Sternberg back in 1929. And by studying where Triceratops occurs in the rock record, we can learn about its evolution through time. The second specimen I'd like to talk about is a small animal called a Pachycephalosaur, which is one of the dome-headed dinosaurs. And so what you're looking at here is the hips of a baby Pachycephalosaur, and here's the upper thigh bone and a string of vertebrae. This was a specimen that was collected back in the early 70s by Dale Russell. At the time, he thought it was a small herbivorous dinosaur called a Thescalosaur. My student, Brian Moore, has studied this thing and has found that it is in fact a young Pachycephalosaur, probably less than a year of age, so effectively a baby. And it's really the first baby Pachycephalosaur that we know about. And so part of Brian's master's work here at the museum is to study this thing so we can extract as much information about it as we can. So the last specimen I want to talk to you about is the skull of an animal called Panoplosaurus. This is the holotype of Panoplosaurus, that is to say it's the first of its kind ever found. When this species was given the name, it was based on this skull here. And my student Marissa Livius this fall is going to be studying some CT scans of this skull. We had this animal pass through a CT scanner at a local animal hospital. And by studying those scans, we can learn a lot about the internal skull anatomy of this animal. So we're going to be looking at its brain, we're going to be looking at its nasal passages, and we're going to learn something about maybe what the animal, how the animal lived, what its ecology was like, but also about what other types of dinosaurs Panoplosaurus was related to. So stay tuned for that. Thanks for watching my video, and if you're anything like me, you're probably a bit of a dino nut, so please don't hesitate to visit our gallery at the museum downtown in Ottawa.
Thank you.